Yo guys, what's going on and welcome to the Crafty YouTube channel. Before I start with my jersey collection video, I want to tell you guys about my podcast.
Yes, it might get annoying that I post my podcast so often here, but it's because I think you guys will really love it.
And one of the iCards, whatever corner that's
you'll be able to find my podcast on there.
You can also find it on Spotify, Apple, wherever you listen to podcasts.
Many would argue that I'm too old to be wearing jerseys.
I mean, I'm 20 years old, I'm out of high school, I work a big boy job here at ESPN.
But I do have a lot of jerseys, guys, and I want to show a bunch of them to you.
So without further ado, I'm just going to grab the jerseys out of my closet. I'm going to show you guys that I'm going to tell you each story of why I have each one.
All right, now first off, I have a Kevin Garnett Boston Celtics jersey. It's the green and black one. It says Garnett on the back. I mean, it's a Kevin Garnett jersey.
Wow. It's one of my favorites and it fits really well. It fits a lot better than I thought it would, to be honest.
But the story behind this jersey is that me, my dad, and my brother are all going to Boston to actually watch the Celtics retire Kevin Garnett's number, and I didn't have a Kevin Garnett jersey that fit me. My only one I had was when I was like 8.
Because if you guys didn't know, I actually grew up a Celtics fan.
So I had to get me one, and I also have one for my dad and my brother that might not be here on time because it did come from Jersey Frost. And you guys know I love Jersey Frost. There's a link down below where you guys can get 10% off already good quality and good price jerseys. But the thing is, they do take a while. For me, they take about a month.
The next jersey is an Obi Toppin Knicks jersey. Now, Crafty, why do you have that? You're not a Knicks fan, you're a Mavericks fan, and the Mavericks are pretty much just all washed up Knicks players.
I have that jersey because I live like 30, 40 something minutes from Dayton, Ohio, and that's where Obi Toppin played college, so he's a pretty big staple here in Ohio.
So I got that jersey for him, plus he has some like really cool dunks, so I was like, hey, I like it.
A common theme that you guys will see with a lot of these jerseys is that I don't like to be in a jersey that other people have. So a lot of these are customized, which you can do in the link below. For Jersey Frost, you already know the deal.
This next one is a Alex Caruso Bulls jersey, but it's not just your regular Alex Caruso jersey. It's your Alex Caruso jersey.
And I got this because we all love Alex Caruso, and Caruso is his nickname, and it's cooler with his nickname on the back than just Caruso.
But after my Alex Caruso jersey, we bring out the Taco Fall Cleveland jersey.
Now, Crafty. Everyone loves Taco, right?
Yes. Yes, we all do. But the thing is, he just left the Celtics earlier this year, or he didn't get re-signed by the Celtics, and then the Cavs picked him up. So I got his jersey then, and they just dropped him like 2 weeks ago.
But then they re-signed him to the G League team, and I'm going to one of the G League games, and I have really solid seats, so I'm going to be wearing this jersey so that Taco knows I'm a real Taco fan.
But in all seriousness, I really like Taco Fall, and I liked that he was playing in Cleveland, and I have Cavs season tickets and I needed more Cavs jerseys. So I got this one.
Me and my girlfriend went to a Cavs game. I actually wore my Jared Allen jersey and she wore that one, and there were so many people that walked by her and go, oh my gosh, that's a Taco Fall jersey.
And that is exactly why I get random jerseys like that.
This is just my next stack, and I think I have two more of these.
So next up, I have a De'Aaron Fox Sacramento Kings jersey. Obviously, he's just a really solid player. I've always really liked De'Aaron Fox. He's one of the best finishers in the entire league that no one talks about.
And I bet people who live in California, especially near Sacramento, see a lot of these jerseys. We don't see these in Ohio.
I actually wore this to the Kings and Cavs game, and I counted. There was 6 other people in De'Aaron Fox jerseys in a stadium that holds, like, what, 20,000 people?
So, yeah, it just goes with the uncommon jersey thing. I like uncommon jerseys.
Now, like I said, I do like uncommon jerseys, but I did have to get just a classic Dallas Mavericks, Kristaps Porzingis. I almost said Luka Doncic.
I had to get his jersey. I got it right after we traded for him. I got it for Christmas. Shout out to my mom.
And my dad. My dad helped with it, too.
But Kristaps was really good at that point, and he wasn't someone that I'd be okay with us trading, so I was like, I gotta get his jersey. Now the story's a little different. He's been playing better this year, but like, I'd be okay if we traded.
And next up, we got a Tracy McGrady throwback Magic jersey.
This one actually doesn't fit well.
So word of the wise, if you guys get throwback jerseys on Jersey Frost, I would order them maybe a size up,
because this thing hugs me and you can see all my crevices.
So I recommend if you do end up getting a jersey like this one, this Tracy McGrady jersey, I would say, you know, get a size bigger.
But I got it because Tracy McGrady, 13 points in 33 seconds. He was an absolute monster on the Magic. One of the most underrated players that we don't ever talk about. One of the best scorers of all time. You know all that jazz. That's why I got a Tracy McGrady jersey.
Okay, but Crafty, what's next?
I am.
This is a custom Dallas Mavericks Crafty jersey. It has the number 12 on it because my birthday is on the 12th of October, if you guys wanted to send me a gift.
My parents got it for me for Christmas. It's really dope. I don't wear it that often anymore because I've wore it so many times. As you can see, it's like getting really kind of like wrinkly and stuff.
But I do occasionally wear it whenever I go to basketball games or whenever I go out in public, because sometimes people are like, oh, I saw you and I didn't know if it was you. Well, my name is on my back now. So
anyway, my next jersey is not even actually mine. I bought it for my girlfriend because this is her favorite player, Boban Marjanovic.
Guys, call Boban.
Listen, we all love Boban, you know, number 51, Dallas Mavericks, played for the Pistons, he played for the Spurs, I mean, he played for the 76ers, he played for a lot of teams, but he is probably the most lovable player in the entire NBA, and he's in trade rumors this year, which I refuse to believe.
But me and my girlfriend are actually going to see the Mavericks play against the Cavs, because the Cavs are the second closest NBA team to me,
and as long as Boban doesn't get traded, that's the jersey she's wearing to the game.
This next one was a gift from my best friend Ian. This is a Luka Doncic Real Madrid jersey, and it's like really cool.
Now, it is like two sizes too big for me, so I'll never wear it, but I definitely will be hanging it up on my wall once I get moved back into my parents' house. This isn't even my room,
but this is definitely a really dope hang-up piece. It's not even from Jersey Frost, so this one's not even part of the advertisement, which basically this whole video is, but I really do love this jersey. Luka was a monster overseas, you know, the MVP.
And when you're the EuroLeague MVP, I should get your jersey, so.
This next one is gonna bring a lot of hate in the comments, but it is a Wilt Chamberlain Lakers jersey.
Crafty, why would it bring hate in the comments? Well, let me explain to you guys why people don't like me with Wilt Chamberlain.
I'll link it up in the iCard somewhere right about now, but I believe Wilt Chamberlain is the greatest basketball player who's ever played.
A lot of people call me an old head, they call me unknowledgeable, but like, I just did a lot of research and I decided that that's what I think, and I had to get a jersey to commemorate it, and I do wear this one quite often
because I've never seen someone else wearing a Wilt Chamberlain jersey, so you know, I gotta flex.
Really dope, amazing pickup. I actually got this one off eBay. It's probably not even real.
For this next one, I got a Carmelo Anthony Lakers jersey because Carmelo Anthony was actually my second favorite player.
Like, my first favorite player was Kevin Garnett, okay?
Because I grew up a Celtics fan, but my second favorite player, the player who became my favorite player the second time, was Carmelo Anthony because I used him in 2K11 or 2K12, one of the two.
And he hit literally three game winners in a row against my buddy Ian.
Is that a valid reason for me to still love him today?
Yes.
Next up, I have an Alexei Pokuševski jersey. If you guys have been watching the streams that I occasionally do,
and the streams that I plan on doing a whole lot more once I get moved into this house,
you guys know that Alexei Pokuševski was an absolute goat on my team, and no matter how high overall players I got at the small forward, power forward position, I always use Alexei Pokuševski.
All right, let's give it to Pokuševski for a couple shots. Oh, right on top of Dirk! As a Dirk fan, that Dirk pack tasted kind of good, though.
So I had to get a jersey to commemorate my love for him, but he actually just got dragged down to the G League, the OKC Blue. So, I don't know if this jersey is that cool anymore, but I have it. All right,
so this next jersey is not Jersey Frost's fault, it's mine.
So when a bunch of rumors were floating around of what City Edition jerseys might be coming out, Jersey Frost would let you pre-order them based on the leaks,
not based off what the actual jersey was. So I got a bunch of these jerseys because I was like, dude, I'm going to get these super early so that when they get here, I'm going to be one of the first people with a Mavs City Edition jersey. So the front is not 100% accurate.
There's supposed to be a basketball here, but that's pretty much the only thing that's not accurate about it. But this isn't just your normal Luka Doncic jersey, okay? This is your normal Huka Doncic jersey. And if you guys don't know the meme, you're either not a Mavericks fan or you weren't on NBA Twitter when Luka Doncic was doing this.
And now we got the last of the jerseys. So now I have a John Wall Wizards jersey because I don't care what anybody says. I got this after he got traded too. John Wall is always a wizard in my heart in his wizard years. I used to love John Wall if you guys didn't know.
Because I used to do John Wall, John Wall.
Okay, that was cringy for a 20-year-old.
John Wall will always be a wizard in my heart, and I always want to remember that. I wore this so much that, like, it's not in good quality anymore at all.
You can see we got fuzz poking out of it and stuff like that. So, it's not very good quality. This came from the NBA store, not Jersey Frost, so that wasn't showing Jersey Frost quality over time.
My Jersey Frost jerseys I've actually found have held up better than my NBA store jerseys.
Next up, another jersey that I'm absolutely in love with. It is my Brian Scalabrine College USC jersey.
If you guys don't know who Brian Scalabrine is, please just look him up, and it's kind of great.
My favorite quote from Brian Scalabrine was just resurfaced by a member of my favorite band, actually.
And the quote is that Brian Scalabrine is closer to LeBron than we are to Brian Scalabrine. And the fact that that's true shows how tough that is.
So I've had this jersey. It was one of my first jerseys, actually. And it also came from eBay. It's probably not real either. But, like, I love it so much, so I hold it very close.
Next up, I have last year's City Edition Dallas Mavericks jerseys that I spilled ranch on this one. It's Luka. And my brother got it for me for my birthday, I think it was. And I'm so mad that I spilled ranch up here because this stain has never come out.
but like it's really cool and I like it and I really love this design. A lot of the Luka ones just don't have stories. It's just because I love Luka.
To continue my Dallas Mavericks fandom, we're gonna be talking about Dirk Nowitzki here, or Dirk Nowitzki, however you want to say it. It's Dirk.
Unfortunately, I was not able to go to his jersey retirement because I've never actually been to a game in Dallas.
Or else I would have wore this jersey, but I just got it because I love Dirk, and you know, I never had, out of all the Mavericks jerseys I have, I didn't have a Dirk one, so I had to get a Dirk one. This one actually fits really well from Jersey Frost, so I don't know, maybe just take my advice on the Tracy McGrady jersey, only for Tracy McGrady jersey.
Next up, we have a 2008-2009 Kobe Bryant jersey. You know, obviously, he's the Black Mamba, one of the greatest basketball players to ever play. Rest in peace.
And for those who don't know, I've actually always been a really big Kobe fan as well, so far that I got this Kobe tattoo on me. You can't see it well, but it's on my Instagram somewhere if you want to go find it, at They Call Me Crafty.
And yeah, I have another Kobe jersey that I'll show you guys here in a minute, but I bought this one and I love it very much. Rest in peace, Kobe. It's a really dope jersey that, you know, I wish I would have ever had the opportunity to get it signed. Sadly, I won't get that opportunity, but it's a really cool jersey, and I love it.
Next up is another example of why you don't trust leaks. It's another one of these Dallas Mavericks jerseys, but it's actually Moses Brown. Around the same time that these jerseys were leaked is when we acquired Moses
Brown. I love Moses Brown. He was actually one of my favorite players on the Thunder, and I like that he's just very tall. I like tall players.
So I'm pretty sure I'm the only person who has this jersey, which is just a Moses Brown leaked City Edition jersey, not even the real City Edition jersey.
Here we have another Kobe Bryant jersey, but it's the Black Mamba Edition jerseys that they had for their City Edition, like, I think it was like 5 years ago, 4 years ago.
But on the sides, it also has all of his accomplishments, like, you know, 18 All-Stars, 30,000 points, you know, 81 point game,
that kind of stuff.
It's really dope. My brother got it for me for Christmas, the same year he got me the Luka Doncic jersey. I still actually really love to wear this one because it's also just really clean.
Next up, we have Jimmer Fredette Shanghai Sharks.
I mean, I feel like if you collect jerseys, you gotta have one of these. I feel like everybody who does collect jerseys has a Shanghai Sharks Jimmer Fredette jersey.
I mean, he's a beast on the Shanghai Sharks. He dropped 90 points one time, 70 points another time. He was just like a god on the Shanghai Sharks.
But, you know, I still like Jimmer Fredette on the Suns, okay? He didn't shoot well. He didn't really play that well, but they didn't give him much time.
So yeah, Jimmer Fredette. Love that.
And the best jersey for last. I saved this one because the story behind this jersey is my favorite story behind this jersey. It is a Patrick Beverley Los Angeles Clippers jersey. Now, let me explain. Obviously, as a Mavericks fan, I don't like the Clippers very much. They keep beating us in the playoffs. Not very nice of them.
I made a video last season when the Mavericks actually ended up taking them to 7 games.
And I said, if the Mavericks lose tonight, I will get whatever Clipper player jersey you guys want me
to. And of course, the top most liked comment on that video is Patrick Beverley. But there was a thing about this comment.
The top liked comment spelled Beverly wrong. So you know what I did? Because I said, whatever the top comment was, I'll do it.
I spelled Beverly wrong on this jersey.
Because I didn't actually want to get a real Patrick Beverly jersey. So you know what? I spelled his name wrong on the back so that I didn't have to actually wear Patrick Beverly on my back. But this is also another example of players that got traded after I bought their jerseys.
When Andre Drummond followed me on TikTok, I bought his Cavs jersey and then he literally got bought out and sent to the Lakers like 3 weeks later. So that kind of stuff happens to me a lot.
I also have a Jared Allen jersey somewhere. I don't know where that's at the moment.
I also have an Andre Drummond Cavs jersey. There's another Luka jersey that's at my other house that I'm still moving out of.
Guys, thank you guys for looking at this jersey collection video. I love you. God loves you. Hope you guys have a fantastic day. Shop Jersey Frost. Check out the podcast. Crafty's out.